Hi guys, this is the DPS device. DPS is short for Digital Phase Shifter. It's made in Korea by Myungyun Electronics Company. I ordered this from Amazon, but later I saw that they also sell this in Lazada and Shopee. The main reason why I have this is that I wanted to have a three-phase power source for demonstrating some of my electrical measuring instrument. So what does the DPS do? It converts a single-phase voltage source to a three-phase voltage for three-phase motor. So even if you have a single-phase electric service and you happen to have a three-phase motor, you can use this DPS device to provide three-phase power to your three-phase motor out of the available single-phase voltage supply. This digital phase shifter is rather a simple device. At its top, we can see the single-phase input terminals, RS. At its bottom, we can see the three-phase output terminals labeled U, V, and W. There are no switches or any other kind of controls. Here we can see the LED light, which will lit up when the DPS is energized. And at its face, we can see the application range of this particular model of DPS. MYPS-2 for 1 to 2 horsepower motor, with input of single phase 220 volts and output 3 phase 220 volts, 6 amperes, 50 or 60 hertz. The DPS is available also for other kinds of horsepower and power capacities, but I chose this one because I have a 1 horsepower motor. The DPS unit that I ordered came in this retail box, sealed and with user's manual, which is surprisingly well illustrated and in color. My DPS is already set up in this small demonstration board that I made myself. The connection is simple. There is a 2-pole single-phase breaker at its input side and a 3-pole 3-phase breaker at its output side. These are terminal posts which I will later use for monitoring the motor. The main power going to this demonstration board will be provided through this cable and plug. Very much similar to the wiring diagram provided by the user's manual, except that I added a three-phase breaker on this side here. And this is that three-phase breaker. Let me just show you a quick time lapse of how I made this demonstration board. A very important application note for the DPS is that it must be used only for three-phase motors, like my 1 horsepower 3-phase motor here. It should not be used for single-phase loads distributed among its 3-phase terminals, but only for 3-phase motors of the correct capacity and matching rating. Having said that important application note for 3-phase motors only, the DPS has two other operational characteristics which should be borne in mind. It's written in the user's manual questions 1 and 2 in the Q&A portion. Number 1. Only 2 phases come out from the DPS output voltage. 3-phase voltages are output only when the motor is running. When the motor is not running, it is normal for only single-phase output to come out. Number 2. DPS output voltage and current are irregular. Initially, there may be voltage and current imbalances, but when the load takes more than 50%, the voltage and current will soon balance. This phenomenon occurs in the process of making 3 phases from single phase. Let's check this one out with a demonstration. I will use my Hioki CM3286 to measure voltage between the 3 output 3-phase terminals. Turning on the main breaker at the input side, the DPS LED is now lit up, meaning this is energized. Turning on the 3-phase breaker at the output side and measuring voltage between line 1 and line 2. The instrument reads 231.2 volts between line 1 and line 2, between line 2 and line 3. Zero voltage between line 1 and line 3. 231.2 volts. So there is voltage between line 1 and line 2 and line 1 and line 3, but zero voltage between line 2 and line 3. This validates the note here at the user's manual, which says that 3-phase voltages are output only when the motor is running. When the motor is not running, it is normal for only single-phase output to come out. Now I will connect the 1 horsepower 3-phase motor and measure the output 3-phase voltages. My 1 horsepower motor is now connected to the output side of the DPS and my instrument is ready for measuring. Turning the 3-phase breaker now to turn on the motor. So voltage line 1 and line 2, 276, line 1 and line 3, 229, and line 2 and line 3, 278 volts. Again, line 1 and line 2, 277, line 2 and line 3, 278, line 1 and line 3, 229 volts. As you can see, I was getting 229 and 278 volts between the 3 phases with the motor running but without load. And this validates the second note at the Q&A portion of the DPS, which says that initially there may be voltage and current imbalances, but when the load takes more than 50%, the voltage and current will soon balance. This phenomenon occurs in the process of making 3 phases from single phase. And because my motor here is just running without load, I was getting a voltage imbalance with a rather high percentage value. Now, since I cannot load this 1 horsepower motor, I cannot check the voltage unbalance at a fully loaded condition. Generally, a voltage unbalance should be kept as low as possible. The rule of thumb is that it should be kept at a maximum of 2.5%. Severe voltage unbalance causes overheating and premature failure of three-phase motors, among others. But in fairness to the DPS, it did warn about these conditions in its user's manual. Before I wrap up this video, I will just check the phase sequence at the output side of the DPS while the motor is running but without load. For this purpose, I will still use my Hioki CM3286-01. One of the remarkable things that Hioki did with this AC clamp power meter is that it is able to detect three-phase sequence using only two test leads. I found out from a previous experience using this in the field in detecting phase sequence is that it is rather convenient to assume first the phase sequence of the test points. That is because the test leads have a particular manner by which you connect them. First, I will connect line 2, which is the black test lead, on terminal 2 or phase B, which I assume to be phase B. And then I connect the red test lead to terminal 1. Once it makes a reading, or the first reading, I'm going to transfer the red test lead to the other terminal, terminal 3, to make a second reading within 9 seconds. After that, when the instrument has detected voltage, it will show me whether the phase sequence that I assumed, 1, 2, 3, or ABC, is correct. Here my Hioki CM3286-01 has detected a phase sequence of 1, 2, and 3. So this is 1, 2, and 3. Now what would the instrument display if I assume that this is line 1, this is line 2, and this is line 3? So let's check that out. So the instrument now detects a reverse phase sequence and it is warning me by flashing the red light on the screen. In summary, for my objective, which is just to have three-phase voltage for demonstration purposes of my electrical measuring instruments, this digital phase shifter served its purpose. It did provide three-phase voltage at its output terminals out of my single-phase electrical outlet. My main concern about the DPS is the rather high voltage unbalance at its three-phase output when a motor is connected but running without load. I have not loaded my motor, so I could not check the voltage unbalance on loaded condition. Still, if you intend to use this, for example, to run a three-phase pump, industrial blower, or machine tool, I suggest that the user needs to be aware of this voltage unbalance. I recommend to verify it safely on both unloaded and loaded conditions, and decide for yourself if the result is acceptable. If you have any comments, please drop them down below. Thank you for watching.